Hello guys, how are you doing? In this visual lecture, we will talk about what is Ploidy number, what is Euploidy, what is Aneuploidy, what is Polyploidy, and all these related confusing terminology. And we will learn all these things in a very logical fashion. So let's start the lecture. Hello, I am Dr. Aizaz from MedicoVisual.com. Welcome to this visual lecture. Starting from very basic concept that what is Ploidy number? Ploidy means how many sets or how many times something is present, how many turns of something is present. Ploidy means how many sets of chromosomes are present. You know, in human somatic cells, I am not talking about gametes, in human somatic cells, we have how many sets of chromosomes normally present? Two sets. So Ploidy number of human somatic cell is
2n.
Two. This Ploidy number is denoted by, it is demarcated by n. So we can say it is 2n. Then there is a similar or related term to this that is called euploid. U means true. Ploid means how many times something is present, right? So euploid chromosome number is said to be euploid when this number is multiple of n. Let's make it more clear. For example, one of the type of euploidy is monoploidy. What mono means one. So what monoploidy means that we are having one set of chromosome. So 23 multiply by 1, again it is a multiple of n. So here 23 is n and 23 multiply by n is 23. So if a cell is having 23 chromosomes in the form of one set of chromosome only, then we will call it monoploid. That cell is monoploid cell, right? And the ploidy number of that cell will be 1n. Similarly, an example of that is, yes, gametes. Let's suppose sperm, it is having single set of 23 chromosomes. Here, this is an ovum, and it is having single set of 23 chromosomes. 23 multiplied by 1. So, gametes are monoploid. Now, you will say gametes are haploid. I will tell you what is the difference between. Don't worry. Similarly, there is a term called diploid or diploid. Diploid means, again, we are having, di means 2. We are having 2 sets of 23 chromosomes. So 23 multiplied by 2, 46. Again, this chromosome number 46, it is multiple of n. N is 23. So if we multiply 23 by 2, it will become 46. Again, it is multiple of n. So diploid is a type of euploid and ploidy number is 2n. Example of that is
somatic cell.
This is representation of zygote, and from zygote onwards the complete human that will be formed, all of that human cell will be diploid cell. And these diploid cells, their ploidy number will be 2n. So these are two related concepts, but you should not confuse these two terms. They are different terms, but they are very related to each other. Then there is triploid, that is, there its ploidy number is 3n, 23 multiplied by n. Clear? Example of that related to humans is that, let's suppose, normally what happens that this is an ovum and it is fertilized normally by a single sperm only. But sometimes really more than one sperm, let's suppose two sperm may fertilize it. Then this sperm will be containing 23 chromosomes, this will also be containing 23 chromosomes, and 23 chromosomes will be of this ovum. So 23 multiplied by 1, 2 and 3. So there will be triploidy here, right? And then there could be tetraploidy, pentaploidy, hexaploidy and so on. Anything beyond diploid, anything beyond diploid is also called polyploid. Now let me tell you something interesting. Some organism other than human, for example some plants, some fishes and some plants, for example banana, their cells, they may be normally polyploid. Normally humans and most of the organisms are diploid, but some organism may normally be polyploid. Right? They may be, for example, tetraploid. For example, some species of wheat, they are normally hexaploid. Right? So that is something normal for some organism. But if a human is polyploid, that is not normal. That is an abnormality, and we will discuss later about chromosomal aberrations. Now, what is haploid? Haploid simply means half of ploidy number of somatic cells. Whatever the chromosome number of somatic cell is, if we divide that chromosome number by 2, that is called haploid. For example, here we are having 46 chromosomes. In this somatic cell, we are having 46 chromosomes. If we divide this 46 by 2, the number that will come is 23, and that 23 is haploid. So normally human gametes are haploid, right? Human gametes are normally haploid and they are also monoploid. Now let's suppose an organism, not human, any other organism, if that organism's somatic cells normally are tetraploid, right? Its somatic cells, they are normally, let's suppose, tetraploid, then their haploid is not monoploid, then their haploid will be half of tetraploid, that is, their haploid will be diploid. So for human, monoploid, for human and many other organisms, monoploid and haploid means the same. But actual meaning of these two terms are slightly different. So you must have clear and logical sense of these terms. Now let's talk about numerical chromosomal abnormalities or numerical chromosomal aberrations. We will try to classify them logically, so it will be very easy for you to understand. Numerical chromosomal aberrations can be of two types. It could be a euploid abnormality, in which the chromosome number is a multiple of n. Now you may be confused here that how euploid may be an abnormality. Let me tell you. Although the chromosome number is multiple of n, but somatic cell is not diploid. You know, normally human somatic cells must be diploid. So if human somatic cell is something other than diploid, their chromosome number is not diploid but still a multiple of n, then that is euploid type of chromosomal abnormality. For example, polyploidy, as I have already discussed, that two sperm or maybe three sperm, they may fertilize a single ovum, that may lead to triploid and tetraploid, and both of these are actually polyploid situation. What about oligoploid? Oligoploid means that somatic cell is not diploid, but it is less than diploid. It is still multiple of n, but less than diploid. It means it may be monoploid. My friends, there is no monoploid situation in humans. Human body cannot tolerate monoploid situation, right? Cannot tolerate monoploid situation. It needs two sets of chromosomes. to function properly. So there is no oligoploid, at least in human as far I know. Maybe there may be some oligoploid situation in other organism, I'm not sure about that, but humans, that is not possible. So euploid abnormality and the other type of abnormalities, aneuploid. An means not abnormal or not, and euploid means multiple of n. So aneuploid means chromosome number is not a multiple of n. Here it was a multiple of n, but here it is not a multiple of n. And example of this is that normally 23 for humans, 23 is the n number. So it should be multiple of 23, that is 46 or 69 for example. But if it is not that, it is less than diploid or more than diploid. For example, hypodiploid. For example, monosomy, one chromosome is less. Normally it should be 46. So if one chromosome is less, that will be not 46 but 45. For example, monosomy of any of the chromosome. We have discussed these things in a previous lecture. So rather than 46, 45. So it is having 45 chromosomes here. So that is 45 is not multiple of 23. 23 multiplied by 2 is 46, not 45. So it is not multiple of 23. Other situation is hyperdiploid. For example, trisomy, right? There is extra chromosome and chromosome number is 47. And again, 47 is not a multiple of 23. Or there may be tetrasomy, if there is an extra chromosome here, and pentasomy and so on. So monosomy could be of autosomal chromosomes monosomy, but body cannot tolerate the monosomy of autosomal chromosomes. So actually there is no example of autosomal chromosome monosomy, but body can somehow tolerate the sex chromosomes monosomy. And example of that is Turner syndrome. Normally with this X, there should be either a Y chromosome or another X chromosome. If there was double X chromosome, that would be a normal female, or if XY, then that would be a normal male. But with X, there is no extra chromosome in this case. So that is called Turner syndrome, and that is sex chromosome monosome. And then regarding trisomy, again it could be autosomal chromosomes trisomy and sex chromosomes trisomy. There could be autosomal chromosomes trisomy, and three of the common examples are Patau syndrome, in which chromosome 13 trisomy is there, and then Edwards syndrome, chromosome number 18 trisomy, and Down syndrome. And of course all of these will be having 47 chromosomes, an extra chromosome. And then sex chromosome trisomy is that there is one extra X chromosome, that is Klinefelter syndrome. Now how can you remember that which chromosomes trisomy is there? Well, I have a nice mnemonic for you. First, let me tell you, you have to learn these numbers 13, 18 and 21, and the good news is that it is very easy to remember these numbers, because in the life of human, these numbers as a years of age, these are very important. You know, 13 years is the age of puberty, 18 year is the age of majority or adulthood, and in some countries 21 is the age of adulthood, right? So these numbers are easy to remember. Now let me tell you how a baby or a child, a young child, will pronounce these terms. What about Edwards syndrome? He or she will say it like this:
Edwards syndrome. Edwards.
So it sounds like adult. Edwards sounds like adult. So chromosome number 18. Edward adult 18 adult. And what about Down syndrome? How a baby will pronounce Down syndrome? It's like that. So 2-1. So it sounds like 2-1. So 2-1. Down, down, 2-1. And for Patau syndrome, that is very easy. P for Patau syndrome, P for puberty. And the age of puberty is 13 years of age. Right? And what about Klinefelter syndrome? I think it like this. It is feminine father syndrome. Klein feminine and Felter father. Actually, these are the names of scientists, and I am sorry to those scientists that I am making fun of their name, but that is just to make you remember these, right? So feminine father, you can remember that this father is having one extra X chromosome. Actually, here is the mistake in this slide. It is double X. Clear? So feminine father. It is father because it is having Y chromosome. Actually, they are usually non-fertile. So just for the sake of remembering that there is Y chromosome here. And feminine because there is one extra girlish or feminine chromosome, one extra X chromosome. Rather than XY, there is double XY here. And Turner syndrome, I do not have any mnemonic, but you can just remember that in Turner syndrome, there is monosomy of X chromosome. So there is one less X chromosome. So let me tell you something interesting. Normally females have two X chromosomes. And out of these two X chromosomes, one of the X chromosomes is randomly inactivated. It is randomly converted into, you can say, a crumpled ball. It is super condensed, it is super coiled, super compressed, and it is inactivated permanently. And this inactivated X chromosome is called Barr body. And this process of conversion of X chromosome into Barr body is also called lyonization. Right? I will not discuss the details of lyonization, but that's it. That's how it is. So we are having Barr body here. So this is what happens in a normal cell. But in Turner syndrome, there is single X chromosome and no Barr body. No other X chromosome that could be turned into Barr body. Now the interesting question here is that the body, when the female cells, when it gets two chromosomes, one of the X chromosomes, it inactivates anyway. But when it is not getting any of the extra X chromosome, the body is angry, and this leads to Turner syndrome. Why so? That is confusing. Well, the answer is very simple. This Barr body that is formed, actually all of these genes are not totally inactivated. Some of these genes from this Barr body, they are still active and these are expressed normally. Some of these genes, they are normally expressed. And when this Barr body is lost here, those genes that are normally expressed, they will be lost, right? They will be lost, and that leads to the symptomatology, the complex of symptomatology that we call Turner syndrome. So this was about aneuploidy and all these related terms. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, please press the thumbs up button. Please give your precious comments regarding this video, and please subscribe to my channel.